Hi, thanks Polly, and thanks everyone for attending today. And as last speaker, I know it's one where people are waiting for the lunch, so I'll be quick and concise. I have a very good story to present to you. And as we heard first in this session today, talking about re-energising the future, we believe we've got a project that plays a big part in that. So disclaimer that you can trust me that what I'm telling you is all true. But in a quick summary of Kodal, we're West African focused. We have our main focus is the Bougouni lithium project in southern Mali. In addition, we have gold projects in Mali and Cote d'Ivoire. But over the last few years, if you've heard of Kodal, you've heard of our attempt to accelerate and move to development of this lithium project, strategically located in Mali. It's a high-grade, surface pegmatite-hosted project. We have an excellent proven team working with us where we've been able to undertake a significant amount of drilling. We've advanced our project from what you would call a greenfields play through to a defined mineral resource where we're now completing our mining application, which we intend to lodge later this year, and looking to move into mining and development, into development and mining over the next 18 months. What separates us from other juniors looking at the lithium sector is three key things, I believe. Number one, our project is located in a pro-mining country. It's an open pit, pegmatite hosted. We'll be producing a spodumene concentrate that we ship out and sell. Simple mining, simple processing. Secondly, we early on received a significant investment from a strategic group based out of Singapore, backed by one of the Chinese lithium carbonate manufacturers. And with them, we've been well funded through all our exploration and well supported in our technical assessment, both metallurgically and for the development of our processing plant. And finally, a very key factor for future development of an operation is we secured, as part of that strategic investment, an offtake agreement. And that offtake agreement is looking to take between 80 and 100% of the product we produce. The reason we negotiated for the 80 to 100 is that we are looking, or we have been leaving it there as a 20% potential for a further party to come in and take some of the offtake, but our initial investor is very keen on taking the whole lot. So a very good position for a junior explorer and developer to be in. And our team basically is myself as the CEO, very extensive experience in Mali and West Africa in general, strongly supported by our project manager, Steve Zaninovich, who importantly for us has more than 25 years experience in project development and operational activities. Most recently, prior to joining Kodal, was involved with the development and operation of a lithium mine in Australia. So we've got very immediate, relevant experience for us as we're moving into this phase of development. Our chairman is Rob Waldridge, again, a UK-based chairman, extensive experience in corporate and AIM compliance. Charles Joselyn heads up our audit committee, and Charles, again, extensive experience in corporate and accounting compliance, and that's very key for us as we're moving in from a pure exploration play, moving up into a development and mining company. Finally, Chintao Zeng represents our major investor, and Chintao has actually offered us very great support. We're very pleased that Chintao was put forward as a representative. He's a PhD in geology, excellent experience in the lithium industry both in Australia and throughout China, and has given us a great deal of support as we're moving forward in our project. So I just want to say a quick couple of words here, because I guess in a lot of ways I'm preaching to the converted about the changing world that we're moving into, where we see a lot of change towards the green energy future, the acceptance of electric vehicles, and the impact that this is having on a lot of people's lives. And you know, there's key drivers behind that. And number one, you know, we're all aware of the personal demand and people's focus on environment and clean energy. But also we're seeing a lot of government regulation that's driving this change. And finally, a key part of this is the improvement in the technology for the batteries. So as batteries improve in their capacity, they become more in demand, they become cheaper, they become more available, and we're seeing an increasing uptake over the time. And clearly at the moment, China is the leader in this area. They're by far the largest take-up of vehicles and continuing to do so. You'll see United Nations conferences confirming the target of zero emissions by 2050, and the growth that this represents for our industry is huge. So what we have and how we're trying to be part of it is we have the Bougouni project in southern Mali, and on the east side there we have the Bougouni lithium project, which was our starting project. We've actually, over the time since we've acquired that, essentially reset our licenses, and last week we made the announcement of the two new licenses that gives us a further 7 years life here, covering all our known mineralisation and a lot of our exploration upside. So sitting at the Bougouni Lithium Project, we have about 350 square kilometres under licence for the next 7 years, with extensions possible. And it's that area now where we will be looking to lodge our mining licence application, and that's going to be our focus for mining and future exploration. And secondly, located on the west side there, another 250 square kilometres of exploration potential with the Bougouni West project. Two key licences granted to us, about 25 kilometres from our project. A good quality bitumen road joins the two, so in the future we'll be looking to also add additional mine life, we hope, from the Bougouni West project. What we have at the moment is early on when we moved into the lithium sector, the board took the view that we would focus quickly on moving to development. And the key part of that was to identify some prospects we thought that we could move to mining quickly on. And we've announced our early resource on three prospects only, within an area that we've had drilled at least eight targets that have all returned mineralised intersections, and our field geologists have identified many more for future drilling. But our focus has always been get it moving, get it into production, and keep it supported as we continue the exploration. So the key takeaway figure here is 21 million tonnes at 1.1% lithium oxide, a very good starting base for us, and we expect to continue to grow that. The biggest resource is Sogola-Baoulé, and the preliminary resource that we'll start mining on is the Anguillana prospect. And as I said, we've been moving very quickly. We're looking to move to lodge our mining license application. So in support of that, we've obviously been doing a lot of engineering assessment and development of our mining plan. And this layout that you'll see here, and I hope it's clear enough for you, identifies our plan of three open pit mines, as I said, commencing on the Anguillana prospect in the sort of south central of the picture there. A central processing plant that will then take ore from the Sogola-Baoulé, our westernmost pit or prospect proposed there. Finally, with the Boumou prospect coming into production in the later stages. We anticipate that this will have some fluctuation, but the starting point will be Anguillana. It's the highest grade, outcropping, and simple ore body to work on. We are looking at a 2 million tonne per annum processing plant that will incorporate a DMS circuit and a flotation circuit. We're looking to produce between 150 to 175,000 tonne per annum of spodumene concentrate. We will be generating our own power. We think that's the most sensible process to take in Mali, given the West African propensity for power failures. We like to have a steady state operation. This will utilise all other existing infrastructure where available. So we'll be living in the town of Bougouni, which you can see just on the top of the picture there. Regular supply of available workforce and very well located in south of Mali, generally a primary industry location. So what's our development pipeline? And I think we also were very, very happy to put out an RNS on Monday this week that we announced that the environmental permit, so the actual permit for us to go ahead and mine when the mining license is granted, was granted to us this week. And that was on the culmination of an extensive period of environmental and social impact assessment. And you'll be aware, and I'm one of the key people saying this, that Mali is a pro-mining jurisdiction. But in saying that, Mali also has an extensive legislation and environmental regulation process that has to be followed for us to achieve the aim of moving into mining. And we were very happy to work both with the government, with our consultants and our own staff to get that application finalised and approved. And it's a major thing for us now. One more item will be when we lodge the mining licence application, moving that through to a fully permitted phase. So early in 2020, we expect to be a fully permitted mining operation. So the next sort of timeline on here, we have completed our metallurgical studies. We are finalising the processing of our bulk sample through a Chinese plant, which is a 2 million tonne per annum DMS and flotation plant. So as I said earlier, we're intending to build a 2 million tonne per annum processing DMS and flotation plant. So we are now running approximately 800 tonne of sample through a commercial production plant that will give us the final final setup of our processing plant when ready. We've completed the open pit mine design. The plant infrastructure and engineering is all complete. We're finalising the translation of our technical documents from English to French, and I'm sure you'll be aware that, you know, a lot of us technical people, geologists in particular, say a lot of words that people can't understand, and then trying to translate them into another language is very difficult. But we're in the process of completing that, and when that's complete, we'll be looking to lodge our mining license application. And then finally, I know it looks simple on the page here that we're going to go from our application to begin mine construction, but you can understand that there's a lot of work in between those points. But from the time we're a fully permitted operation, we expect to be moving very quickly. And again, I will emphasise that our key strategic shareholder has always been very supportive of us moving to production, has always been very clear of their indications of wanting to help us move through to production. So we will be moving forward with those discussions as we have more concrete items. So just in summary, I think a few quick comments on, again, a very simple slide. We are focused on bringing our Bougouni lithium mine to production as quickly as possible. Lithium is a high demand commodity. It is part of the future change of a lot of people's life. And we think we've got a great deposit that will move into that industry. Strategically located, and that's important, as you know, we hear a lot about sovereign risk and issues around being able to develop mines. Well, Mali is a pro-mining country. We're located in a very quiet part of the country. We've got access to a port via a good quality bitumen road south through Cote d'Ivoire, and the port that we'll be intending to use is the San Pedro port. It's already set up for bulk commodity export. We've got an excellent team, a dedicated team. I've been working in West Africa since 2006. And in that time, I think I've, from probably 2011, the same team's been working with me in Mali and West Africa. So we've got a dedicated, competent team who know what they're doing, who are able to navigate what is sometimes a tricky environment, but we've been able to do it successfully. And finally, we're a team that builds builds on exploration, and our exploration has been a strong strong focus for us over these last few years, but now we're moving into a mine development phase. We've got the people who are very competent working with us on that, as well as the expert consultants that we're all familiar with. So very good team, very good project, moving very quickly. I think over the next year to 18 months will be a very exciting time for Kodal.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Kodal Minerals, Bernard Aylward. And Bernard, as promised, delivering you a slightly curtailed version of his presentation, because of course lunchtime is next. But nevertheless, we do have 5 or so minutes for questions. If you'd like to raise your hand, Thomas is at the back of the room with the microphone. If you'd like to ask a bit about what Kodal Minerals is up to. Oh, look, all those tummies rumbling. No one's got a question at all. I can't believe that. Yes, we have. Just one over here on your right, Thomas. Thank you, sir.
Have you looked at upgrading to an intermediate product on site rather than shipping the concentrate? Because you're going to lose quite a lot to transport costs on a relatively low-value product.
Yeah, I think that's certainly an interesting question, because Mali, as you know, is landlocked. We have a fair transport to the port. That's been a key factor that we've been looking at as we're looking at our mining assessment. We have had some good fortune to meet some excellent trucking contractors in Mali and in West Africa, people with extensive experience. We think we've been able to negotiate a good price for trucking, so we're not particularly focused on limiting the amount of tons that we're trucking out. And I think the issue with saying further upgrade on a spodumene concentrate would actually require vastly more capital, would require a great deal of consumables that aren't readily available in Mali to make something viable. So our proposition has always been that our pegmatite intrusions in our project do actually make a good, clean spodumene concentrate that does generate a ready market. So in a long-winded way, no, we're not looking to upgrade any further.
And what about the cost at the San Pedro port you were talking about? You said they were fairly low.
Yeah, well, San Pedro is a port. It's the second port in Cote d'Ivoire. I can't really give you a per tonne at the moment, Polly, but I will say that our team went to visit the port authorities last month. They were very keen to work with us on developing a storage site, as well as optimising our throughput through the port. So we recognise that there's potential for capacity, as well as support from this developing area.
And presumably, as with one of our other speakers today, a lot of goods coming in from China into Africa through Côte d'Ivoire, and a lot, therefore, empty containers sitting, waiting empty to go elsewhere. Presumably that's something you could take advantage of.
Yes, but we're actually slightly different in that aspect, in that so the lithium spodumene concentrate should be considered more of a bulk sample. So we'll be shipping out into a hold, so we won't be containerized. But one of the key things, as you just mentioned, is a lot of things are imported into West Africa and trucked up into Mali, including cement and including all other materials. And that's actually led to a lot of backloading or empty trucks returning back to the port. So we've also been investigating those and looking to utilize some lower cost transport through backloading.
All right, let's just scan the room for one last question, if there is one. Anybody else? No, it looks like everyone wants to get to lunch, Bernard. I expect you do too. I know I do. Thanks. Bernard Aylward, thank you very much indeed.
Thanks very much.